Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss all the questions of the chapter 1.1 of practical book, that is Python basic input output. Here we will discuss all the solutions of this chapter. Now question number 1 is to ask the user to enter the name and assign it to a string type of variable, then enter age and assign it to an integer variable and print out the name and age in separate lines. Now you can see name is a variable. Here you have to call input function. Within the input function, you can just write enter your name. Now here input function is actually used to read some value which is entered on the console by some input device, maybe some keyboard or some other device, and convert it into a string and returns it. So the return type of input function is string. So within input function, you can just pass any string as parameter also. Like here we have passed enter your name. Now age is another variable which will store the age which will be entered by the user. So by default, the output or the return type of input function is string. We have to convert it into integer by converting it into integer type by using int function. So within int function, we have to call input function. So that whatever value will be entered by the user, that will be converted into integer and is stored in a variable age. Now you can simply print name is name, age is age. And you can see the output like this. It will ask the user to enter the name. The user can enter any name and it will ask to enter age. And can enter any age, but that will be taken in string. You have to convert it into integer by using int function. Now it will display. Now give 3 examples of legal and illegal variable names. So as you know, the legal variable names can be, the name can consist of any letters, but it should not take any special character except underscore. And it can take numbers also, but it should not begin with numbers. So the legal variable names can be roll underscore number is a legal name. The subject or anything which contains only text or letters, that is a legal name. Now suppose code 1 or any text with numbers in it, but numbers should not be at the first place. So those are the legal variable names. Now some illegal variable names is roll dot number. Here dot is a special character which is not allowed while naming a variable. Now suppose one code. One code is a variable where the name begins with a number, which is not allowed in Python. Now for, we have taken for as a variable name, but it will not be acceptable because for is a reserved keyword. All these keywords like for, while, all these things will not be accepted as a variable name. Now identify the errors in following codes. The first code is like this. Y is equal to mx plus b. So here actually mx is not defined. First of all, you have to define the variables. And second thing is that mx means m into x. So if you just write mx, that means it is considered as m into x normally. But while you are writing program, you can't write it like that. It will not consider it as m into x, rather it will consider mx as a single variable. So since you have to find out m into x, so you have to specify the into operator, multiplication operator. So you can write y is equal to m into x plus b. Like this you can write to get the output, and m, x and b values should be defined also. Next is cofactor is equal to alpha into x. Here alpha and x are the two variables which has to be defined first of all. The second thing is first order is another variable which is storing 1.0 divided by cofactor. So here you can see the variable name is beginning with a number which is not allowed. So this is one illegal variable name. And the second variable also second order, it also begins with a 2 which is a number, and this is also not acceptable. So this is also considered as an illegal variable name and it will give error. Now, what built-in function is used to convert string 85 into a floating point number? And what built-in function is used to convert a string into an integer? And what happens when you try to convert a string into an integer, but the string is not a number? Now, let's see. Now, here s is equal to 85, which is within double quotes. That means it is taken as a string. Now, to convert it into floating type, we have to use float function. So float, within that you have to pass the variable s, which is storing the value 85 in a form of string. So this will convert this string into corresponding float. Now x will store the value 85.0. If you print x, then you can get the output as 85.0. Now to convert this into integer, you can use int function. Int function is used to convert a string into integer. So you can write I is equal to int, within that you can pass the value s. Now if you print I, then you can get the output as 85. Now suppose it contains one string value which is not a number. Now let's say s1 is equal to str within double quotes. Now if you try to convert this into integer, then this will give you some error because this is not actually a number but a string which cannot be converted into number. So it will give some error like invalid literal for integers. It's not the proper value for integer. So these are the outputs. Now next is, what would be the output of the following code? Now it's printing does not. Here you can see in between one apostrophe, one single quote is there, which is prefixed with a slash. Then print does not, same thing, but here it is kept within double quotes and the quote also prefixed with a slash. Next, print yes, he said, like that everything is kept within the single quote. And next, print yes, he said, and here you can see the double quotes are prefixed with slash. So in all these cases, you'll get the output like this. First, we'll just give you doesn't with a one apostrophe. And again doesn't, and say the next yes he said with the quotes which are there in the statements, all those things will be printed. Now the thing is that we can say that the string can be represented within single quote or double quote. You can write either in single quote or double quote, either way it is considered a string only. But if a single quote present inside the string, then prefix it with a backslash or keep the entire string in double quote. Like suppose in your string there is a single quote which is appearing, then better to keep the entire string within double quotes. Otherwise, it will, wherever it will find a single quote, it will consider it as the end of the string. Similarly, if your string contains one single quote or double quote in between, then keep the entire string within single quotes. Or else if any single quote or double quote is appearing inside your string, then just prefix it with a backslash. In that way, it will be taken. Now write a program to print an acrostic poem as shown. So what is acrostic poem? This is nothing but certain letters in each line form a word when you see vertically. Now here in this case, you can see the words, the letters P, E, A, C, E, R, aligned in the same line if you see vertically, making a word piece. So you just have to write like this. There is nothing to do, no programming is done over here. Simply you have to just write, giving the appropriate spaces so that these particular letters will appear like one top of the another like this. So you can get the output like this. Now the next question is about ASCII art. So ASCII art is also known as computer text art. It is done by smartly placing the special characters or letters to make a visual shape. Python also provides many libraries for ASCII art, and here we will know about a simple library that is called ART. So ART is a Python library to convert text to ASCII art. Only different kinds of text we can convert it into ASCII art. Apart from that, some predefined pictures are also you can make with ASCII art. So for that purpose, you have to install one library called ART library. Then you have to import it in the program. So once you install this library art, then you can just import it into your program, like from art import star. So it will provide you different functions by using which you can do some ASCII arts. So one of the functions is text to art. So this will convert one text into an art form by using some ASCII characters, all these special characters. So we are passing one string called Python, and it is stored in a variable called s. And this function will convert this string into ASCII text. And you can see the output is like this. Once you print, then it will be printed like this. Then apart from that, there is one more function called aprint, so which will take a predefined art name. There are some predefined art name, and it will print the corresponding one line art. So here I have passed in aprint function one is butterfly, so it is displaying one butterfly art. Then second one is aprint happy, so it is showing like some happy face. Then aprint angry, then aprint sad, then bird. Like this, there are many predefined art names are there. You can try them. So apart from this also, there are many more functions which are available by using which you can do some nice ASCII art. But here in this program that is given in your question, you have to draw some images. So to draw images also, there are other modules and libraries available in Python. By using those libraries, we can convert directly, you can create ASCII art from one given image or picture. But we will not do that. That much is not there, that is out of the scope of your syllabus. So you will just use the print statement to do the arts which are given in the question. You have to draw these figures, so that it will appear in that form. You have to use all the ASCII text, those are available in your keyboard. All the special characters you can use to make the images. So we will do that. Now write a program to print ASCII art as it is shown. So here also there is nothing much to do. You just have to write print statement, and you have to give all these symbols or special characters in proper position. So what you can do, you can see the figure is already given in the book. So you can just initially begin with a print statement by giving some 6, 7, or 8 spaces. Then give one underscores, making a line like this. Then in between give some 15 to 20 spaces. Then again you print underscores, which will form line. Then in the next line, you can see just below the underscore, you have to print this backslash, front slash, all these symbols which are used over here, mainly underscore or symbol and this brackets and all these things. That's the special characters, all the special symbols are used to form this art. So there is nothing to do. You just check with the figure and just go on writing the print statements so that you'll get the corresponding output. You just have to remember how many spaces you have to give in between. So there is nothing to do actually. You just go on typing and just see the output, how you are getting it. So you can do it easily. There is no difficulty in doing this one, and can get the output like this. Now you can see the output is coming like this. Now same thing, write a program to print another ASCII art. So here also you have to write the print statements. But here you can just notice one thing, that some of the places there single quote is appearing and some of the places double quote is appearing. So wherever single quote is there in your figure, just the entire string you keep it within double quotes. And wherever double quote is appearing in any of the lines, then you just keep that string within single quotes. Then it will give you the proper result. Otherwise, you have to just put the slash, underscore, bracket, the stars and all these symbols to get this output. You just have to align properly while writing the print statement. You have to make sure that which symbol has to come after which one. So you can just go on writing this one and you can get the output like this. And this is how the output looks like if you write the previous code. So you just try it yourself and There is no programming to be done over here, and I don't think you will be getting such type of question in your exam. Just for fun, you can just do different kinds of ASCII art. Now here is the solutions of practical book chapter 1.1. Here we have discussed all the questions which are there in Python basics chapter input output. And if there is any doubt, you can put it in comment section. And stay tuned for more solutions and do subscribe. Thank you.